In this video tutorial, I will show you how to create search form and also how to filter data in PHP. So stay with me. Hey, what's up guys? Sinead here from KonigPassiveIncome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they will do it on day one. So, if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So before we even start with this tutorial and write actually the code, I want to show you on my whiteboard the basics of that you need to understand for this tutorial. So what we are going to do is we'll create one input. So this will represent some search query, and this is where the visitor will enter what he is looking for. And then we are going to create one dropdown here, and visitor will be able to choose whether he wants to search for based on first name or based on last name. And we are going to have one submit button. Let's say we will name it find. So this is basic HTML form. And if you don't know what are the HTML forms, basically we have some inputs, and for our HTML form we have two methods. The first method is get, okay, and the second method is post. And depending on the type of the form that you are getting, in PHP you can expect the data from those inputs by using get and by using post. And that is all that you need to remember. So when we go into the process of creating form, you just have those two things in mind. And the last thing that I want you to understand is how to actually write the query in SQL that will actually search something in the database. So the query will be select, and then here we are going to write the column names that we will actually select from the table if there is any data. So for example, we will say select first name, and then we need to say from, and then we will write the table name, and let's say we will name it users. And after that we are going to make one condition, so we will say where, and after that, depending on what we have here, we will search the data. This, so we will say where, for example, the visitor selected column name is last name, and then we will say like, okay, and this search query. So let's say it will be query. So those signs means that anything before this query and after this query will be just ignored. And the only important thing that we are looking in the column last name is this query. So just remember, the things that are always the same are select, from, where, like. So those are the things that are always the same. And we will just say select column name, from table name, where column name, like this query. And this query in SQL will just give us the result that we are looking for. So let me now use my PC and actually show you how to write the code that will put all those things together. So now, once you understand the basics and what you have to learn before you start with coding search form, let me now show you how to actually write the code. So now I'm here at my PHP Storm, and I have just created new project and started my localhost XAMPP server. So I'm going to create a new m2php file. I will name it search.php and hit OK. And now first we need to go and create some database and the table where we will store some data. So I will, in my PHP my admin, go to the new, write the name of the database. I'm always using UTF-8. Okay, and hit create. And let's say we will have table users. And we can say we have four columns. So I will say he ID. Okay, and we'll have first name, let's say 50, last name, let's say 50, and let's say email, again 50. Okay, and just hit save. Okay, so now we have table PHP search and we have table users. So let's now just quickly insert some users. So I will just open website fake name generator.com just to get some random name. So let's say we'll use this one. Okay, email is not important, so let's get another one. This is just some test data for this tutorial, but I want to show step by step how to do it. Okay, and let's insert one more. So we have now three users in this database and that's all what we need. So like I said on my whiteboard, first thing that we need to do is to create HTML form. So I will just write some basic HTML code. Okay. And here I will say form method, I will use post action, I will use this file, and let's say I will have one input type text, name cool, and placeholder. And now let's say I will have one select so that users are able to select what they are searching. Is it first name or last name that they want to filter? So I will say here name column, and let's say they will have two options. First options is first name. And the second option is last name. Okay, and we are going to have one submit button. So let's now just open and check that we created correct form. So yes, we have one input with type text. We have the filter, which is first name or last name, and we have find. We can just here say select filter. Okay. So now they will choose what they want to find. And if they click on find, nothing will happen because we didn't make any PHP code so far. So now we need to know when someone pressed this button to detect that. So let's say submit, and in the PHP we'll say if isset post submit, which means if someone pressed this button, the code be here will execute. So first thing that we need to do is we will accept the informations from this form, but let's connect to the database. So I'll create new variable, connection equal new my SQLE, and here I will specify the host, which is localhost in this case. I will specify the username, which is root in my case, and the password is an empty string. And the last option I will give here is the database name, so that we later don't need to use select database query. So I will just say here PHP search. Okay. And now here we can say coo equal post coo, which means in the variable coo we will store whatever the user, the visitor input here. Okay, so let's now just test that to see what will happen. Okay, so that's it. But the problem here is if someone try to break our system, we don't have any protection. So we need to do real escape string for any data that is entered in the form. So I will say connection real escape string, and on this way our form is much secure than if we don't do this. And the same thing we are going to do for a column. So I will just do this column, and now we need to check which column someone chose. So if let's say column equal empty, so it means if the visitor didn't change this, so he didn't choose first name or last name, let's say the default column will be first name. So what I did here is basically, this is like some protection if someone is trying to manipulate the data in the dropdown. So I'm saying here, if a column is empty, or column doesn't match first name, or column doesn't match last name. So if someone manipulated this data, we are going to make a change here, and we will set a default like first name. Otherwise, it will be whatever the user, the visitor has chosen. So now all we need to do is to execute query and find the data depending on a selected dropdown. So we will say data equal connection query, and here we will say select, let's say first name from the name of our table is users where, and now we are going to say the column like, and now we need to specify here the query. Okay, so we'll say, I will write like this and put in here query. So what this basically means that anything before and after this query will be accepted, and all we are looking for is those words inside the query. So now we will just check how many rows we have. If data num rows bigger than 0, that means that we have some data in the table for this search query. Otherwise, we will just say echo . So now we can test this. So let's say we'll just hit here something like this and select first name. It says your search query doesn't match any data. But if we try to insert any name, let's say this, and we select first name, we click on find, then here is an empty because this part here is executed, but at the moment we don't have any code, so we are going to write it now. So I will say let me just rename this. I will just say SQL, and we'll say here while data equal SQL fetch array, we can say echo data first name, and we will concatenate string, and let's input one new line. So let's test now, refresh and say continue. You can see we have got the first name David C. But if we now try to search for something, for any first name that is starting with this character, we can say like this and put search filter first name, hit find, and as you can see we have found those two visitors. And if we now try to change this and say we are searching by J and we are searching by last name, when we click find, we have found Louis M, which means that on this way we have created search form, and also we are doing some filtering of the data, so the visitor is able to choose first name or last name. So guys, pretty much that's it. This is, I hope so, very basic and easy to understand tutorial. All you need to remember is the things that I showed on the whiteboard. So if you guys have any questions or problems with the code, just let me know in the comments below. And also if there is anything else that I can do for you, just let me know. Take care.